Do we focus on what is unseen? Welcome to Coffee with Pastor B.
Give me your eyes for just 1 second. Give me your eyes so I can see everything that I keep missing. Give me your love for humanity.
In times such as these, I've heard that phrase a lot in my life, but I never truly knew what it meant until now. Times such as these. It's times such as these that we have something eternal to hold on to. It's times such as these where we focus on what is unseen instead of what is seen. That's what Paul's trying to tell the Corinthians here in 2 Corinthians 4 and verse 18. He's trying to tell them, focus on the things that last. Focus on the things that matter in this life. Because in the end, they're what we cling to in times such as these. 2 Corinthians 4:18 says this, while we look at not at the things which are seen, but at the things which are not seen. For the things which are seen are temporal, but the things which are not seen are eternal. You know, you may be feeling kind of beat down right now with the temporal, with the things that are seen, with the things that we are hearing on the radio, with the things that we're seeing on television, with the things that we're seeing with our loved ones, with the things that we're dealing with or experiencing as part of this situation in our crazy life that many of us have never been a part of. And yet, everything's going to be okay. 2 Corinthians 4:7 through 10 may describe a little bit of what you're going through, but also the hope of what we are. It says this in verse 7, but we have this treasure in earthen vessels, so that the surpassing greatness of the power will be of God and not from ourselves, that temporal thing. For we are afflicted in every way, but not crushed. We are perplexed, but not despairing. We are persecuted, but not forsaken. Struck down, but not destroyed. Always caring about in the body the dying of Jesus, so that the life of Jesus also may be manifested in our body. It's the duality of the Christian nature. We are both dead and alive. In our flesh, we must die. In our flesh, we will die. But in our spirit, we are alive. We are eternal. We are both the temporal and the eternal for those who are in Christ Jesus today. People keep saying, and rightly so, this too shall pass. You bet it will. It's going to pass like a kidney stone, but it will pass. We're going to feel beat down and persecuted, and we're going to feel these things acutely that are really taking on to us. But the scripture tells us that in all of these things, it's not quite as bad as we think. For we are eternal beings, so that while we carry around the dying flesh, we too carry around the life of Jesus Christ for all of those who want to have hope. That's what 2 Corinthians 4 is all about, is our straight duality as Christians. We are both dead and we are alive. So we can either focus on the things that are temporal or we can focus on the things that are eternal. And I challenge you to focus on the things that are eternal today. Do not let the enemy win. Do not let the enemy have a foothold. Lift your eyes to the Lord. Focus on the eternal, which is Christ Jesus. Focus on the eternal, which is salvation. This world is not my home. I'm just a passing through. It's a great old song my dad used to sing. He used to play it on the guitar. And I love that song. It's one of my favorites because it reminds me that this world is not my home. I'm just a passing through. The eternal is where I reside. It's where my heart must lie. It's where my mind must be. It is a great honor to be the church at times such as these. Remember that. Remember to shine your light. Remember that you are a part of Christ Jesus if you are in Christ Jesus today. Because it gives me great hope, and I hope it gives you great hope. If you're not in Christ Jesus today and you happen to stumble upon this, I ask that you reach out to your local church organization, your local pastor, your local friend who knows Christ Jesus. Ask them about this Christ. Ask them about this eternal thing that I'm talking about here. This hope. For in the end, we have faith, we have hope, we have love. And you can be eternal too. The kingdom is forever. It will not stop. It will not fail. While things might look a little dreary and grim, this is just temporary and it too shall pass. Solomon tells us in Ecclesiastes that this has all happened before and this will all happen again. There is nothing new under the sun. For the kingdom will go on and we will continue to bring hope to the world, for nothing can stop that. Nobody can close the church, for we are the church. Nothing can stop the gospel message of Jesus, because it goes forth by the power of God. So let the word of the Lord bring you hope today, and may you be blessed, and hopefully found a little nugget of love, hope, and peace in this message. Thanks for joining me for a sip of coffee and a look at the word.